Judge William Murphy Jr., attorney for the family of Freddie Gray and former circuit court judge for the city of Baltimore, and Amy Meredith Cox, assistant professor of African American studies at Fordham University and the author of Shapeshifters, Black Girls and the Choreography of Citizenship, which is now officially added to my reading list. All right, I'm going to go straight to you, Billy Murphy. On these claims by officers about Freddie Gray.
Strip search people.
In, on the side of the road.
So we have to talk about.
And then rape them.
Right? But we have to talk about police violence and this larger history of the sexual assault of black women in this country. This is a continuation of a historical legacy. And we really don't talk about how sexual has played out in policing until recently on black women's bodies. So if you think about the fact that black women make up roughly less than 15% of the population, and 60% of those black women before the age of 18 have experienced some sexual assault, right? And for every one woman that comes forward and talks about this sexual assault, there are 15 others who say nothing. So if you think about the public shaming and silencing with sexual assault, and then you have a case like this, where a woman can be violated on the side of the road in public by an officer of the state who's there to protect, what does it mean for all of the other women and girls who have been sexually assaulted? So this trauma, this terror, I would say, is not just about these individual cases of Sandra Bland and Coralie, but what happens to the larger population of black
power,
women and girls
it's
in
about
this
authority,
country.
And it's about the assertion of that power and authority, and don't let anyone question.
Well, the question I would have also is just getting the allegations out, even if you don't have anything to substantiate
it
them, and
the
getting
jury,
them in the Washington,
right?
Baltimore.
It taints the jury pool.
And the larger public, right? So this is about narratives not just that are fought in the courtroom, but what happens in public opinion. It's very strategic. So in some ways, it matters less whether or not these allegations are true, but what it does to not only delegitimize the fact that black men and women and even children are being killed across this country and have to prove their humanity in the face of this killing, but also this larger narrative of collective protest, right? It's a way to squash these collective challenges to state violence.
Legitimacy here is the key word.
Right.
Because what we've seen over the last few years is the delegitimizing of versions of what happens. Mm-hmm. There's something that happens that the police claim the person caused for themselves because they were afraid, and the community and everybody outside looks at the same set of facts or what they know and say, no, that's not really what we observe. So more and more we're seeing the police side sticking to one version and the public realizing that what may have happened is something very different.
Right.
What we need to look at is why are we in this situation over and over again?
Well,
and my conclusion is that poverty, inequality, racism, and guns just don't mix.
Yeah.
Well.